oranges. You're X-raying oranges.
I thought you'd like that. I've got a growers collective up north that wants a machine to sort out the bad ones. X-rays show the bruises inside, but I'm still trying to figure out how to cover every angle. Yeah, you know, comprehensive imagery of organic tissue is a hard nut to crack. Plus, with the amount of oranges, they need like 1,000 machines.
That seems like a lot. Is for orange juice?
Indeed.
Ah, I'm late for a patient. It was good to see you, Ilya.
Same to you, Bill.
You should roll them.
What?
The oranges. Roll them through the X-ray.
Oh, yeah, good idea.
Headaches. They're all the time.
And the memory loss?
Yeah.
Okay, so with the shelling you took in Okinawa, it's likely these symptoms are due to hematomas.
Hematomas?
Yeah, bruises on your brain. Look, Jim, these X-rays aren't giving us enough information. If we don't get a good look at your brain to determine what's going on, it's likely these symptoms you're having could worsen, and very quickly.
I'm better off on my own.
Jim.
The invention of the CT scan was critical for understanding brain injury, but in many cases, brain injury doesn't show up on a CT scan. The problem we're mainly targeting in this particular project has to do with challenges with near vision after TBI concussion. Things might be blurry, they might lose their place on the page while they're trying to read, and this can be really challenging for tasks related to schoolwork or employment. Our virtual reality equipment now has the ability to see how the differences in their eye movement, control, and coordination relate to the symptoms that they're experiencing. What we can do with VR is make that a much more interactive experience. We design games to treat these problems.
What they'll do is put on a virtual reality headset, and they'll hold on to a controller, and we will show them a series of apps.
We can kind of set it at the level of each person's own problem and deficit.
A few of my grandparents had strokes. I was very close with my grandparents. You know, I think, unfortunately, you know, I wasn't able to do anything for them, but you know, I hope through my work, I can benefit others who are affected by brain injury.
It's really about an opportunity to help people who've served and given their lives and make their life better.
I was in combatives. It was on the first day. Another gentleman picked me up and slammed me on the back of my head. I lost a lot of memory. After the incident, when I transition from different levels of light, my eyes are physically painful. Sometimes my eyes don't focus at all. Right now, I am studying anatomy and physiology and medical terminology. It takes a lot longer for me to remember and understand what I'm learning. I try to concentrate, and then I'll get a headache or stressed out with hopes to get into the radiology technician program. I have to get help so I can meet their requirements. Dr. Walker had mentioned the VR when he asked me to be a part of it. Truthfully, my initial thought was no way. I get to be involved so we can perfect the therapy. I want to help other people because I know it's a struggle. I am eager to see other veterans participating, trying to reach an end goal of just happiness.
I hope we can make the assessment and treatment of ocular dysfunction after traumatic brain injury very much available.
So that veterans are able to read, to do their schoolwork, to get the employment that they, you know, want and deserve.
I want people to be more aware of the injuries that you don't see. I just feel it in my heart that I know that I should be here. I should be working with Dr. Walker and Dr. Fu, and we can make something big out of this.